Technology entrepreneurs like Elon Musk are at the foundation of many of the things you use today and will love tomorrow. They are the ones that came up with a technological idea and solution, believed in it, assembled the resources, put a lot of effort in it, and actually made it happen. But we do not need to go that far to find an entrepreneur, though. There are also technology entrepreneurs closer to home. Consider Cecile van der Waal, a U20 alumna who simplifies user interfaces for 3D printing that help to make this radical technology accessible for the masses with the printer company. Or consider the environmental scientists David Strick and Marjolein Helder from Wageningen University and Research, who developed the technology to generate electricity from living plants. This has resulted in the foundation of Plant E, a company which now sells modular systems to generate sustainable electricity. But how did they start as technology entrepreneurs? How did it all begin? What was necessary along the route, and what lessons can we draw from other entrepreneurs? The first entrepreneurial myth is that entrepreneurs know exactly what they want and how to get there. Think about the way towards a successful venture as a journey. Just like a real journey, the entrepreneurial journey has a starting point, several stations where you can get out or stay on board. It also has an end. Some steps of the way you can plan ahead, but very often you will change the way that you initially thought you would be going. Sometimes you may even need to go back. To add to the complexity of the journey, there may be multiple starting points. So let's start at the beginning. Are you ready? At least four starting points can be considered. Some have a technology or an idea and already know who will be buying and using the product or service. For example, Plan E has found a way to generate electricity from plants, which is a sustainable solution for those living off the grid in remote areas. Some do not have a technology, but know that a problem exists that they want to address. Take, for example, the problem of plastic garbage floating around in the world's oceans. Would it not be fantastic if you can engineer a bacteria that can eat garbage? Some do have a technology, but do not know which need they can address with this. For example, generic radical technologies such as nanomaterials can be used in health applications, but also industrial engineering or agriculture. A key task for an entrepreneur is to go out of the building and discover potential customers. Finally, some have neither the technology nor the potential market. They have dreams and maybe a vague vision of what they want to achieve. Here, the entrepreneurial journey is likely to be most complex. Take, for example, Elon Musk again. For a SpaceX project, many technological issues are not yet solved, and it is unclear how many people or companies will be using the service. Whatever starting point you have, there are three key activities or challenges that will keep you busy when you decide to dive into the entrepreneurial journey. The first is to further search for potential ideas and solutions around you. The second is to actively create possible ideas, alternatives, and solutions. The third is to further sharpen your ideas and solutions by critically evaluating them to decide which ones to pursue further. This is what scholars refer to as opportunity identification, creation, and evaluation. It is in the early phase of your journey that the luggage that you bring to the start plays a crucial role in successfully taking the necessary first steps. To be precise, your personal knowledge, for instance, what you know about technology, skills, for example, social skills, and attitude, being proactive, play a crucial role here. But what personal luggage is helpful and which may be a burden? Let's clear up a second widespread entrepreneurial myth about knowledge. Successful entrepreneurs are those that dropped out of college to get right ahead with their venture, right? After all, famous examples of Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, and Mark Zuckerberg come to mind. Research shows, however, that higher education in technical and managerial sciences can boost the growth of tech ventures. Education can provide you with the knowledge and skills to become a successful tech entrepreneur. Being an expert in your field of technology and the industry helps. You know where the problems and challenges lie, and thus also where your technology might be of help. Still, schooling is not the only helpful item in your luggage. There are many options that you need to explore along the route, which require from you to evaluate which directions to take. This is where prior experience is helpful. From studies on expert entrepreneurs, we know that those who have started multiple businesses evaluate ideas differently than those first time out. This is because they use different frameworks to evaluate business ideas. Simply put, if you have traveled parts of the journey already a few times, you become more experienced and know which aspects of your idea or technology warrant additional attention and which do not. For example, where novices only look for novelty, experts pay more attention to whether an idea truly solves someone's problem or whether the idea can be connected to a network in a specific ecosystem. Let's continue with another widespread myth about skill, in particular social skills. Entrepreneurs are those who are suspicious about authority and find it difficult to work with others. After all, Bill, Steve and Mark are usually in the limelight alone. But if you take a closer look, you will see that almost all great business ideas are not the result of just one man or woman. When two ideas collide, the result might be an even greater idea. Great ideas are often the result of interaction with significant others. Bill had Paul Allen, Steve had Steve Wozniak, and Mark had his Harvard roommates. Social skills are thus helpful luggage. They include your ability to work in teams, your ability to share ideas with others outside of the team, and to sell your idea to investors and your product or service to customers. In particular, the Lean Startup methodology advocates to go out of the building and to interact early and often with key stakeholders of your potential venture. Besides knowledge and specific skills, also attitudes, motives, values, and traits will influence your ability to start up a business. These aspects are more hidden in a person but can be very important on your journey. One of the first questions you should ask yourself is why you want to start your entrepreneurial journey and what keeps you motivated. Are you in it for the money? Do you want to create value for a community? Or do you want to change the world at large? Testing your deeper drivers is helpful as you will become aware of the more hidden luggage that will help you to make decisions along the way. You can start testing your values in the Startup Values Test and the Goals and Values Card Game. A second test concerns your willingness to learn new things. In the journey you will face, you have to learn a lot of new things. Initial business ideas often need to be reshaped substantially as the entrepreneurial journey continues. Successful entrepreneurs exhibit a large degree of learning orientation. It means that you have a strong desire to develop yourself by acquiring new skills, mastering new situations, and improving new competences. You can do a short test to discover your learning orientation. The third and final test concerns how strong you believe in yourself. The entrepreneurial journey of a tech entrepreneur requires a strong belief in your own competences, a healthy dose of optimism and resilience. You can imagine that not everybody is immediately enthusiastic about your idea, and it is likely that you need to change direction along the way when a new application context emerges and other people come on board and join your idea. By now, you may think that the technology entrepreneur is a jack or jackie of all trades. Maybe in the ideal world, he or she is, but as they say, a jack of all trades is a master of none. Reality is that more and more tech starters are in fact not soloists, but teams. So forget about the final myth, the entrepreneur as a heroic individual. Many startups, either independent or corporate, have a team origin. The typical first question from an investor to a technology entrepreneur is, "Tell me more about your team." Team formation challenges are about finding complementary skills. At a deeper level, they also have to find complementary motives and values. Once this is achieved, teams compensate for human capital such as knowledge, skills, attitudes, but also for social capital like access to specific networks. However, don't forget, also your startup mates will need to explore their journey just as you have done so far.